detective. You're supposed to wear white socks, aren't you? What color are your socks?
So this will probably teach me how to talk to girls, right? No, I'm joking. I'm joking. Hello, my fellow viewer. Yes, you. Today, guys, I'll be reacting to China Moon, which came out in 1994. Yeah, guys, all I know is that Ed Harris plays as a detective, and that's all I know. I have not seen anyone react to this movie so far, so I'll be basically the first person to react to this movie. So give a round of applause for that. Anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoy my reaction. Like and subscribe for more movie and anime. And yeah, guys, let's get to it.
Orion Pictures Release. A TIG production.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
Madeleine Stowe. I gotta tell you, Madeleine Stowe in the 90s, I saw some interviews in the 90s, and let me tell you, she was a sight to look at. Okay, this music, the score definitely feels more romantic, like the romantic score.
Dorsha.
Okay, so we know where this is going, guys. You know, they're in a motel. We know what's gonna happen. I'm just gonna blur this whole part out. Hey, she got a stalker. What the heck? The one and only Ed Harris and his sidekick.
Fix your collar.
Oh, he's that guy from Star Wars, right? The episode 7 or 8?
A robbery going on here.
What time is it, Dickie?
9:01.
Tom, you done with the photos?
Yes, sir.
You get something close on this blood trail here and the butts in the ashtray?
Yes, sir.
Oh, so this is like kind of like a murder mystery movie. Dang, this woman was stripped down, naked, and killed? What the? Did they really bring a hearse out? Hearse?
She hasn't been gone long. What's her name?
Felicity Turner.
Married?
Yeah, has a daughter too.
Lamar says maybe rape and robbery.
So where does this like take place? What state?
See that hole in her head? You know what that is? Hard contact wound is what that is. You gotta be angry enough to press the gun smack against the head to do that.
Oh wow, he's like a pretty smart detective, man.
Started getting the idea his life was over. So he drags her out of the bathroom into the kitchen, trying to make it look like a rape. Goes back into the bathroom, begins to clean the blood off the bathroom wall. Never heard of a rapist or robber.
Wow, he's imagining he's a killer. That's amazing.
Entry because it wasn't a rape or robbery. It was her old man. You find him, you find a gun that put the bullet in the bathroom wall.
So was it her, did he mean it was her father that killed her or her brother? I don't know.
Well, her husband was just picked up at the bus station with a .32 caliber in his BVDs, and they're taking him to the office.
Lamar, you shouldn't be doing this. This is nothing that a man like you should be spending his life at.
Well, let me guess, he's gonna say he should have went to college and became a doctor or a lawyer.
Talk to me, baby. Tell me what I want to hear. Say that you love me. That I was there.
Ah, Madeleine Stowe, the one and only.
Your love and affection.
Yeah, that's how I would have reacted if I was there. I ain't gonna lie.
I know you're not alone.
Why does he look so stiff singing? Like, he's not making any movements or nothing. He's just, like, he's scared.
Hello. Mind some company? So why are you here?
And I have. I can't help admiring real effort.
So was she the one that took the pictures at the beginning? Oh, wow. So that was her husband. So did she hire somebody to take pictures of her husband, I guess?
Where were you?
Playing cards, I told you. I don't want you out here drinking anymore.
Oh, so he's one of them husbands. Okay, he's very protective of his wife. Too protective, actually.
Rachel? That's your name, isn't it? Rachel Munro.
I'm sorry, I didn't recognize you. I didn't have my contacts.
Kyle Bodine.
Rachel, you already know.
Wait, how did he even know where she was?
Maybe I'll call you anyway.
I'll call the police.
Call me.
Her expression changed.
How much is that?
This one? You want with a big...
God, golly, who is she trying to murder? Her husband? Oh, wow, I guess her husband is pretty abusive too, huh?
Did she forget to feed you again?
Well, how am I acting? Like I'm having a wild sexual affair?
Okay, so this is all like...
Sit down, goddammit, I'm talking to you.
Just about her husband being too abusive, I guess.
Sure. Where? Yeah, what time? All right, I'll see you then. Bye.
Oh, that sounds like Rachel. He's smiling. He knows something.
Married to your work? Real detective. You're supposed to wear white socks, aren't you? What color are your socks?
So this will probably teach me how to talk to girls, right? No, I'm joking.
Where?
Do you carry a gun?
Yes, I do.
Where? What kind is it?
It's a 38, 2-inch, snub nose.
I wonder if she's like really crazy in the inside, because she did buy a gun, so.
Bye, honey. Take care now.
You too.
Dang, they didn't even kiss on the lips. They just kissed on the cheeks. What the freak? Hey, looking pretty good in that dress. Of course.
My grandmother used to call that a Chinaman. Like a big old plate of china.
Hence the movie name. Pretty cool.
Said people would get affected by them. Do strange things.
Do you believe that?
You're so beautiful.
I don't blame him.
You ought to jump in.
It's okay.
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Jeez, on the first date too? Okay, the whole body and everything. Oh, wow. Romantic, but also wrong, because she knows what she's doing.
Why did you cry, Rachel?
I don't want to talk about it, not when I'm with you.
So does he know that she has a husband?
You've got the most boring life a man ever lived.
It's always important, everything you see, every minute of the day. But you don't see nothing, because you're bored.
Then why'd you partner with me? I mean, you had a choice.
I keep hoping you might surprise me someday.
Man, she dressed up in everything. Okay, wow, there's like more romance in this movie than anything else.
So, how is you?
Who?
You're Cinderella.
So how does he know about, Rachel?
You think I'm gonna take her away from you?
Anything up for you?
I got nothing going on.
Fuck you.
What, are you gonna get upset?
Perhaps.
Please don't, Lamar.
I mean, why would he be upset about that, though? Like, what?
Take me for a ride?
And this?
I will never forget.
I look like she wants to tell him something.
You gotta decide. You either stand up to him and leave him, or you stay with him and you try to work it out.
You should have never gotten in this situation in the first place, detective.
Rachel, my God. What are you doing here?
I wanted to surprise you.
77, domestic in progress, 201 Cypress.
CID 159, we're close. We'll respond to 201 Cypress.
Police, everything's fine.
Sir, you live here?
Nothing happened.
Oh, the wife called the police.
Where's your wife, Mr. Munro?
She's inside. She's fine.
I'm gonna take a look inside your house.
Nothing happened. This is stupid.
Are you all right?
You gotta call. He knows I'm seeing someone there.
Do you want us to arrest your husband?
Lamar, I'll take care of this. Get back outside with Munro.
Damn, he went straight to, do you want us to arrest your husband? I don't think that's how it should, that's how it goes, right? First you have to ask questions. Too much questions like
don't
that.
Don't touch her again. Who are you talking to?
You.
Okay, he's making it very obvious that he's going out with Rachel.
Don't have to put up with him. Divorce the son of a... Get rid of him.
Oh. Oh, she didn't tell him that her husband was abusive. Okay.
I bought a gun.
Where is it? I want it. Where is it?
Don't.
What?
Don't! Let me go!
Rachel!
I mean, what is she doing? There's a detective. She could have talked to the detective about what was happening to her instead of letting it go. Instead, she wants to kill her husband now.
Man, how about yourself?
Let me see. I need you to make a call for me.
Sure, man. Anything you want.
I want you to call the police.
I thought you was the police.
Pack of smokes.
Okay, why would you do that? Why would you make him call the police?
97877, domestic in progress, 201 Cypress, BPD 184-1099.
201 Cypress, that's Munro's place, isn't it?
Oh, okay, I see what he did. So he made his dealer, or whatever the guy, whatever his name is, he made him call the police.
What do you want?
One of your neighbors reported a woman here calling out for help.
She's in Miami.
Oh, that was the woman that the husband went had sexual relationships with in the beginning of the movie, right?
I don't care about him anymore. I have to be with you, Kyle. I'm sorry.
It's kind of sad. All she wanted was some affection in her life, and she needed to get it from someone else, not her husband.
You want me to come in with you?
No, if it comes home, you can't be there.
How much time do you need?
15 minutes.
All right.
Huh, so she's just going to pack her bags and just leave, huh? It ain't going to be that easy, though.
Rachel, are you coming or going?
She's gonna have to put up a fight. Get out.
Don't!
What you got in here, huh? Everything but...
Speak out!
You're not going anywhere!
No!
Yeah, she gotta get out. She got to get out.
Get away!
Rachel.
Get away! Oh!
I mean, she didn't have to resort to that, but hey, that's her fault.
Oh, Jesus.
Right in the face. I don't think she had to do that. She could have just shot her in the kidney and just left. But nope, she decided to kill him.
Threw me against the wall. He wouldn't let me go.
I gotta call the police. It's justifiable homicide.
You can't. It's an unregistered gun.
That's your fault, lady. You getting this detective into more and more trouble.
God help me, Kyle, please.
Yeah, help her by calling the police.
Okay.
The love for another person can lead you to do some bad things, man. I mean, I don't want to sound like a murderer, but this should have been a better way to take care of the body, like incinerate it or something. Or I'm not trying to sound like a murderer, guys. I promise. I mean, the trucker can expect the whole truck, right? Even the roof. That's what they do, right? I feel like they're gonna miss something. Like the detectives are gonna catch up.
You have to move. Call his office. Wait a day. Then call the police.
How come you're so quiet about this girl?
What do you want?
Why is he so fixated on the girl? Like he keeps asking questions about Rachel.
Hi, June. I'd like to speak to Rupert, please.
He hasn't come in yet, Mrs. Munro. We're trying to locate him right now.
Well, would you have him call me when you do?
When was the last time you saw your husband?
The day after you were here.
Thursday last?
Yes. It's the day I went to Miami.
And you came back yesterday?
Mm-hmm.
Did you call your husband at any time when you were in Miami?
Okay, so this is a time when the partner is going to prove is how good as a detective he is.
Has he done this before?
Has he done what?
Traveled unexpectedly.
Did you notice anything funny about the house when you came back?
Dude, I feel really scared for the Ed Harris. I really do.
How long has that been broke?
A couple of weeks.
Had a break.
Closing it, I think.
I'm telling you, this detective is gonna find something, but he ain't gonna tell him.
Window was jammed. Didn't move.
Yeah, that's all.
She was lying.
What's up?
It's his car.
I mean, they could have reset the numbers on the odometer, right?
They're gonna want to see you again.
Why?
They found his car. They're gonna ask you some questions.
I'm scared.
It's gonna.
Yeah, you should be. I don't blame you.
This was murder. Someone knew what they were doing. Was no cuckoo bird. What was the argument on that night?
You don't have to answer that.
My husband was accusing me of having an extramarital affair. And in the morning, I called a taxi. He took me to the airport. Then I took a 10 o'clock flight to Miami.
You were there Thursday through Sunday, returned.
So the detectives are probably going to call the airport and check the hours or something. I don't know what they're going to do.
I phoned my husband's office. I spoke to his secretary.
Who else did you call?
No one.
I feel like the detective thinks that it's Eddie Harris that was with him, or Ed Harris. I don't know Ed Harris's actor name. That's why I call him by his real name.
Mrs. Munro, we're going to want to take another look at the house. Saturday night at 9:37, she called her husband here. Got him just before he went out. At 11:41 p.m., she called him again at the Brayton Country Club.
See, she screwed up. She's not really she can't really hide her tracks that well.
What kind of stories?
She used to entertain men when her husband was away.
Hi.
Thanks a lot. How's it going, Lisa?
We haven't found anything yet.
All right.
Man, I know Detective Kyle is like sweating in the inside.
Who called Munro from your room? You put someone in there and you came up here to kill him.
I didn't.
Tell me the truth, goddammit.
Oh, please, I am.
Yeah, it was a planned murder.
Somebody's lying. This doesn't make any sense.
I need a hand.
So. Wait, I think we got something.
Yeah, they found it.
You got yourself a big old murder, Kyle.
Yeah. Man, I tell you, you can tell from Kyle's expression. You don't even need to hear him say anything. You just know he's screwed.
Gas scorching. Exit wound lateral to second vertebra.
Don't know all these doctor words, but I do know that he got shot 2 times.
Looks like a 38.
Yeah, maybe a 9mm. Practically the same.
38. Something wrong?
He's really showing that he's like a... He's seen a murder or something. But didn't Rachel have a 9mm gun?
Her lover boy or someone came in. There was a struggle. The victim was hit in the head and shot twice. I think he ran the damn humidifier to melt down the prints.
We'll find a print somewhere.
Nice job, detective. I wonder about those pictures. Like, who took those pictures in the beginning of the movie? Like, Rachel hired somebody to take those pictures. I thought they got rid of all the bullets, though. I thought Kyle and Rachel got rid of all the bullets.
A perfect 38. Look at them riflings.
You been sleeping with anyone other than me?
No. Why are you asking me this?
See, she's a crazy one throughout this whole movie. Huh. And unfortunately, Detective Kyle got trapped into her web.
Where's the gun?
What gun?
The gun you shot him with.
He threw it away at the truck stop.
The bullet they took out of your husband's body was shot from a 38. The bullet they took out of the wall today was a 38.
This is the bullet that was taken out of the wall at Munro's house. This is the bullet that was taken out of Munro's body.
What are the pits on the bullet that came out of Munro?
I don't know.
A sand will pit a bullet like that, won't it?
Jeez, how did he know exactly where the bullet went? So someone else knows about the murder, not just Kyle.
Her husband filed a complaint with us. Said you used abusive language. Did you say that? Munro was shot with a 38, wasn't it?
According to the autopsy report, yeah.
You carry a 38 special, don't you, Kyle?
You know I do.
May I see it?
Oh, wow. So they're pointing it to Kyle as a murderer? Oh, wow. So Rachel set him up.
I'm putting you on administrative leave until such time as we know that.
You're the one who gave him the wrong gun.
What?
What are you talking about?
Wrong serial number. You didn't give him your gun. Gotta tell you, Kyle, you got a lot of people upset who can't believe you've done something like this.
What the? Does he notice something about the compass?
Don't know.
You never went to her house to see her?
No.
You're gonna fry for this and she's gonna walk. Now that must have been what she had in mind all along, don't you think?
But how was his weapon switched though? Like how did he not have his own weapon?
She'll be real rich. She's gonna get $12 million.
Wow, so she did it all for the money. Oh, is that the same compass Kyle saw in Lamar's car? So it might be Lamar. Wow.
You got my money, Lamar?
You got the ticket? You'll get the rest when I get mine.
How much did you pay Dickey to follow your husband? Rachel, start talking.
He's going to leave me with nothing. Lamar told me how to do it all. Set up Rupert's death. Where to meet you.
Kyle just, I guess, fell for it all? At the perfect time.
Phone calls from your room.
Lamar must have put somebody in there.
Who made the phone calls from your room?
I don't know.
I just want to know the truth. Mm. Tell me the truth!
I am!
It was that other lady with the blonde hair.
Why didn't you tell me? You were just...
Yeah. He's going to prison.
I was loving you and you were... me!
Hello, Dickie boy. Kyle. I went to school on you, Kyle.
You sure did.
I listened to everything you told me. I don't see my name on it.
You see the compass on your dash? You switched my gun, didn't you? My 38. You shot it into sand, and then you got the bullet.
Wow. So he switched the bullet?
You got a desperate imagination, my man.
Where's Kyle? Let's go.
Someone's gonna die tonight.
Give me the goddamn gun.
In my car.
How much were you in for?
A lot. The lady was desperate. Then she wanted to call it up, but the money smelled too good.
Why me?
Yeah, it was all for the money.
Come on, open it up.
So all it took was for Rachel to look at Kyle at the bar in the beginning of the movie, and that's how this all happened. Right?
Stop right there!
He's
got a gun!
In all honesty, Kyle, it was his fault. It wasn't his fault, but he shouldn't have gotten involved in the whole relationship, you know? He had it coming. He had it coming, of course. Okay. And the movie ends with the China moon, of course. Okay, so it seems like Rachel was going to prison and Lamar and Kyle are both dead, so no one gets away. Wow. Alright guys, so that was my reaction of China Moon. Here are my thoughts of the movie. I enjoyed the detective work, especially from Detective Kyle. Plot was okay. Basically about a woman just trying to find her way in life. And the way she did it was by using Detective Kyle to get out of her relationship. What I didn't understand about the movie though was the very beginning of the movie. Because we're at the bar scene, right? Where Detective Kyle and his partner Detective Lamar at the bar. Now, if you guys watched the whole movie with me, you would have remembered when it was mentioned that Detective Lamar set the whole plan up for Detective Kyle and Rachel to meet up and have a relationship. But I just had this one question to ask. How was Lamar gonna set that up? Like, I would have expected Lamar to tell Detective Kyle, hey, I want you to meet Rachel. No, instead what happened was Detective Kyle just looked at Rachel at the perfect time, in the perfect moment. Bam, they hooked up later on in the movie. That's what I just didn't understand, that certain part of the movie. But all in all, I enjoyed the movie. If you guys enjoy my content, guys, like and subscribe for more movie reactions. Have a great day and keep your heads up.